sun. We've no less days to sing God's praise than when we first begun. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me.
One of the hardest things you ever do, and maybe you have to preach your buddy's funeral. I've been put through the test. But those that don't know me, I'm Jimmy Sturgess here out of Waycross. And me and that cat rider was close. Real close. Matter of fact, we were so close to when he go to leave, and I'm gonna explain this in this journey that we having here through this conversation, is we learned the golden word, it's called love. That man go to leave, he get in that truck, and he walked the truck two or three times before he'd actually get in it. And before he left, he made it a point to say, "My brother, I love you." You know, I was born in a family of 10. There was five of us boys, and I think I was closer to him than I had any of my birthright brothers. You know, we just had that relationship. And I'm quite sure each and every one of y'all have, because I'm looking around this building right here today, I see a bunch of familiar faces. And I could write a story, like I mentioned a while ago, I could write a story off of each and every one of you. I mean, Wayne, he admired you. Some of the stories might not be good, but some of them's gonna be wonderful, I promise you. But he didn't really have no bad thing to say about no one in general. Anyway, Eddie Wayne Stone. I sure didn't know his first name was Eddie, because I'd had a lot of good laughs out of that. You know, when we'd get angry, I'd have called him Eddie. But he was my friend Wayne. But says his date of birth is Wednesday, September 21st, 1955. Place of birth, Waycross, Georgia. Date of death was Saturday, December 17th, 2022. Wayne was 67 years old, 2 months and 26 days. I tell you, his daughter's probably could tell you the seconds. On his obituaries, he said, "Mr. Eddie Wayne Stone, 67, died Saturday, December 17th, 2022, at his residence. He was a native and lifelong resident of Waycross. Wayne retired from the Ware State Prison as a correction officer. Wayne was preceded in death by his father, James Edward Stone, his mother, Johnny Mae Davis Wayne. Survivors, two daughters, Christy Sheffield, Jackie McIntosh, Tony Powers, both of Millwood. He had some grandchildren he thought highly of, I'm telling you, this man was obsessed with his grandchildren. It was Harley Sheffield and Adeline McIntosh. And this is a power punch right here. His aunt that he loved dearly. I'm telling you, I could about write you an encyclopedia on this woman from the stories he told me. You are his backbone. I promise you, you are his man's backbone. Miss Lita Dunsmore of Waycross. He had some amazing brothers I've known most of my life. Stevie Swain, his wife Pam Cox, Christopher Swain, with his wife Stephanie, and Daryl Swain with Cindy. Nephews and nieces, Christopher Swain Jr., Matthew Swain, Zachary Swain, Alex Swain. And he had numerous aunts, uncles, cousins, and very close relatives. But Wayne, in our journey, you know, me and Wayne had, man, I tell you, like I say, I could stand here and talk to you about Wayne forever. So do you have you laughing and probably make you cry. But he's an amazing guy. But I'm so relieved today to know that Wayne did know God. So if you got any questionable doubts, if you want to see him again, you need to look up, not down. He got curious as I made my transition into serving God. Wayne, you know, we were friends. And Wayne would come over and talk with me. And so he got kind of curious. So you talking about two old Georgia rednecks talking about the Lord. You know, so it gets on a different level. And I had to figure that out because that's what it took for me to recognize the good Lord. So me and Wayne were sitting around talking one day, and he asked me, he said, Jimmy, he said, what makes us do bad things when we know they're bad? I said, well, the Holy Bible teaches us that. And something you can remember today, the word Holy Bible, he only left you basic instruction before leaving this earth. That's basically what it represents. And I would talk to Wayne in that manner, and he said, well, that makes a lot of sense. But we got to talking, and I told him, I said, Wayne, let me get on a level. And I said, I'm going to speak to you as man to man with the Word of God in it, so maybe you can understand it. So I got to tell him the story about Lucifer. You know, he was God's archangel. And there again, they had a relationship like me and Wayne had. God and Satan was actually close to the point where he addressed him with onyx topaz, just the greatest gems that's out there, was on his armor to represent the high of God, you know. So all the other angels, whenever he get the blessings, would see that. God wanted him to stand out. So the first argument they got into, whenever Satan put in to steal a blessing, the Bible, as you read it, says he cast him to the ground. He didn't stop and say, give me all my stuff back, like a friend would argue. He said it cast him to the ground. So whenever he hit that ground, all these precious gems and jewels burst off into the dirt. So me and Wayne was talking, it kind of confused him a little bit. He said, I'm not quite understanding, Jimmy. I said, well, this is the deal, Wayne. I said, later down the journey, old God and Satan was having a conversation. And old Satan kind of looked up at God and said, oh boy, he said, who's your praise and worship leader now? I'm not up there. And God said, oh, you want to see? He reaches in that dirt where all these topaz and gems were at, and all this gold, silver, and he picks it up, and he blows life into this dirt and said, here's Adam. Otherwise, what he said, here's Wayne. Here's Chris. Each and every one of you are designed. God made perfection. We screw it up. But he made perfection in each and every one of us. And that's when I got to tell Wayne the story about that. He said, man, that makes a lot of sense. And I said, well, now, the answer to your question is, why do we do bad things when we know not to, but we do it anyway? I said, the simple fact is, the old devil's on your back because you got what belonged to him, what he used to once have, what you're made of. It's to the point whenever God, Satan, and Jesus went up on the mount, and the devil told Jesus, said, if you'll just fall to your knees. He didn't say, take you humble down and kneel. He said, if you'll fall to your knees, I'll give you all this. That's what I tell him about that. If I could have been there that day, I'd start laughing. I said, man, come on. You trying to give this dude what he already has? It's instilled in each and every one of you. And that's what I used to preach to Wayne all the time. And it got to where he'd come to the house. If he didn't have nothing else to do, out of boredom, I mean, we joked and cut up like everybody else. Worked on stuff, tore stuff up. But we always wound up bringing some Christ into it. And the Bible has taught me as an individual, where two and more gather, he's in the presence. And it's like I told Wayne, I said, every time you mention to someone about Jesus Christ, you calling God in your presence, buddy. And he got to knowing that. And then he got to the point where he said, a situation coming up through the family or something, and he come over and talked to me. He said, Jimmy, I've learned to pray for him. So you know what I told me? That dude is a believer. Because the simplicity of the Bible teaches us all you have to do is to believe. That's what gets that party started. Then it revolves to something else. You know, so what I'm trying to happen here is to the point about how Wayne's beliefs was. You know, each and every one of us has a field. A And I was sitting there thinking the other night, last two nights, I sat there, couldn't hardly sleep at night, trying to think what I'm going to talk about my friend. You know, trying to convince somebody that's going to be all right because he left us. But I'm going to tell you, he made enough memories to keep you alive, to keep him alive. So don't never let it go, because that was an amazing man in my book. I'm sure he was in y'all's. You know, but I was sitting there trying to think about what to talk about, and first thing running my mind is, boy, I know old St. Peter's catching trouble up there, because Wayne's trying to tell him how to work that gate a little bit better. He's trying to tell him how to oil it or what to oil it with. You know, but that was Wayne. And like I say, you got to have people in your life. That's what makes this life complete. You know, he's an amazing man. I mean, I was telling my wife about it the other day. I said, I'm going to be lost. She said, I know you are. I said, because I don't know if I got his stuff at my house or my stuff at his house. Because that's the way we operated. If he walked in my place and he found something, your prime evidence, I promise you. If Wayne seen something, he'd asked you about it. And you're going to give it to him before he leaves. Because you know why? Because you done been to his house and he loaded your truck down with something. Whether you wanted it or not, he wanted you to have it. My wife said, what are you doing with that chair? I said, well, his aunt let him give it to him. And he didn't have nothing else to do with it. So he brought it to my house. I said, what you going to do with it? I got a rocking chair that I'll bring to you. It's in my shop that comes from you. It was in my church. I could not do away with it. So I put it in my shop. You know, because that was something precious to him, and he wanted me to have that thing. You know, but he's just an amazing man. I'm sure you're going to miss him. I've lost a lot of friends. As we get older, you know, we're going to find out. You think, well, everybody's dying off. Hey, people, we're getting older. Your great friends are leaving us. I've had, well, Donnie Price, you know, Friday, he just left us. I mean, they're dropping like hot, but it's called we're getting older. Our generation is climbing the ladder. We're going to have a few more of them. But I just hope one thing. I hope I got a friend left in this world that will stand up here and do what I'm trying to do for this man, because it takes a lot. And I'm not trying to make it about me. I'm just trying to tell you, I had a relationship. I'd go to the end of the world with this guy. You know, and I mean, it stands true. But they got another song to play. Wayne probably telling me right now, okay, you said enough. Time to sit down. Yeah, let's go ride a motorcycle or something, you know. But anyway, they got another song to play. I'm going to let them play that, and then we're going to close in a prayer and proceed on to follow up with the funeral. But I thank you for coming.
Gathered round your grave to grieve, wish I could see angels' faces when they hear your sweet voice sing. So go.
would by you. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day, dear Lord. We ask you to give us peace with the losing of our great friend, these relatives, this father, brother, aunt, the uncle. Just give them peace and deliverance from this situation, dear Lord. I know we stayed trying to figure out why you do the things you do instead of accepting it, dear Lord. We don't know what's in store for the future. We understand that you have the grace. Dear Lord, you have the power to count every hair on our head as it falls out and it comes back in. But yet still we try to deny the fact of why you do the things you do. But we just want to thank you for it, dear Lord. We ask you to give peace in this situation. Dear Lord, as we go through this journey, dear Lord, we just ask you to keep the memories open of our brother Wayne in these hearts that's fulfilled throughout this day. Dear Lord, we just thank you for each and everything you do. We want to thank you for paying the price, dying on the cross for our sins. In Jesus' holy name, amen.